Many of us know the feeling of being sick but still having to leave home to buy medicine, or the chore of bundling the family into the car for a trip to buy forgotten dinner ingredients. This is even more challenging when the closest shops aren't just a few blocks away, but in the next town, or where leaving home just isn't an option. This is where remotely piloted aircraft, commonly known as drones or RPAS, are already being used to quickly deliver goods and parcels to Australians. And their use is only going to grow.
Wing is offering a drone delivery service here in Australia for a number of years. Every single week, we deliver thousands of packages to people in Canberra and in Southeast Queensland. Items ranging from over-the-counter medication to hot prepared food, groceries, hardware items, and we have a delivery taking place almost every 30 seconds across a number of different facilities.
We founded Thrillbearer in 2017 after we got asked a question around whether a drone could be used to move chemotherapy medication in the Australian outback. We knew straight away the answer was yes, the technology could fly far enough and carry the right weight and all that kind of stuff. But we thought the real question was, what does a system look like that can do that flight 1,000 times a week in a, you know, safe and scalable way?
For drone deliveries to operate at scale, it's important that there's a level of social acceptance and appetite for this technology. And with that acceptance comes an expectation that the technology is safe and communities feel assured that a regulator is keeping industry accountable.
It's important for the community to understand there is a regulator like CASA that oversees safety. So people, when they look in the sky and see a drone, they know there's a safety regulator that is thought, you know, that is accounted for that drone operator, that the city is aware of it, things like that as well.
Being able to work with an aviation regulator like CASA is really, really important because people trust the aviation regulators. And so I know that when we're talking to the Malawian communities or the DR Congolese communities or the Mozambican communities, being able to say, we do this in Australia and we've been approved by CASA to do these same type of operations is very powerful.
Automation will be a key factor driving how these drones will be used, which for industry will increase scale, reduce overheads, and bring down prices for consumers.
We see automation as an absolutely critical piece to the puzzle, particularly in UAS, as well as in advanced air mobility. But being clear, going beyond automation and going to autonomy. And that autonomous piece, where we will have an augmented environment, will be critical from a safety point of view as well.
Australia is a good location for the development and trial of these technologies, but it is crucial that operations are conducted with a high level of safety.
At Wing, we've had the pleasure of working with CASA for a number of years to make the safety case that enables us to operate in the Australian skies. And that work was world leading. And now other countries are looking to CASA's work that was done with Wing here in Australia to inform decisions being made about drone safety and drone delivery in other jurisdictions.
So this is known as outcomes-based regulation. And what that basically means is that CASA doesn't prescribe exactly the things that an operator needs to do in order to safely conduct an operation in a given setting. Instead, the onus is on the operator to show to CASA how they'll safely do that to manage the risks that have been identified. And this approach is really flexible, and it allows operators who are wanting to do new or innovative things to come to CASA and demonstrate to us how they can do those safely without necessarily having to follow a prescriptive list of particular controls or procedures that might not actually make sense in the context of the operation that they're looking to do.
CASA has really demonstrated global leadership in this space. They have a very high bar for safety, which is important for a company like ours, as we're one of the first companies doing work like this. So going to a country and working with a safety regulator that had a high bar for safety was very important. But in conjunction with that high bar for safety, CASA always also took a forward thinking and a forward leaning approach to how they would assess this.
Find out more on our website.